So if we think of how does the skin waterproof itself, so it appears then that in the bottom of the epidermis you have these cells that are moving upwards towards the surface, and as they move upwards they build these fat globules within them that are then, when they get close to the surface of the skin, are released, so that you have protein in the cell wall, which is the brick, and around it there's fat, and that's the mortar. And the fat, you know, this is a complicated process and variation of fat in individuals and in various locations, but essentially those fats are made up of cholesterol, free fatty acids, and ceramides. Now, ceramides, there are many different kinds of ceramides, but it appears to be a very important part of the waterproofing of the skin. In individuals that have, say, eczema, there may be a defective protein called fillagrin, which then translates to the barrier effect and the lipids not being normal. So given that, it is realized that if you supply the skin with some of these ceramides, that you can maybe salvage the situation, that many of these ceramides can be then taken into the cells and then extruded and make better mortar to keep in the water more effectively. So it's a very important sort of step forward in learning that barrier function is critically important, and that maybe there is this medicine, as it were, these topicals that can help replace the deficiency in ceramides. So they're very, very important advance, probably in terms of moisturizing and barrier repair.